hacen ya párate. Y ahora sí, transmitiendo desde el Foro Digital, porque tenemos una invitada muy especial, mi estimado Facundo.
Se iluminó la cabina.
Se iluminó la cabina. LP está con nosotros.
Hola, hola, ¿cómo estás?
¿Cómo estás? Nice. ¿Cómo estás?
Bene.
¿Qué tal?
Laura Pergolizzi. LP está con nosotros en México. Laura Pergolizzi, para el italiano.
Did you suddenly become Italian? What happened?
I know.
How are you, LP?
I'm very good, thank you.
Yeah, it's not your first time in Mexico, right?
Yeah, no.
No.
So,
no.
For what you came to Mexico?
I came down here for Corona Capital.
Okay.
Yeah, very excited.
Yeah, I will have to do a translation, if it's okay.
Okay.
So we're going to ask in Spanish and in English, and we're going to do everything because people is listening to us in the whole. En México. Y la gente también nos está viendo a través de las redes sociales. Entren a Facebook de los 40, a todas las plataformas digitales. LP va a estar en el Corona Capital. You're going to be in the Corona Capital.
LP is going to be in the Corona Capital.
Wow, that's very distracting.
But actually, you have like something with Mexico, right?
Because I have a lot of things with Mexico. What do you want to know about it?
No, we were talking about like, you like Mexico, you want to have a house close to El Ganso in Baja California,
maybe,
Los Cabos.
Or, I don't know, maybe Mexico City, maybe in, you know, Puerto Escondido. My friends have houses there, but I don't know, man. I'm definitely going to live in Mexico for a while.
Okay. Tiene cuates en Puerto Escondido.
Exactly.
So,
está nice. What about Mexico? Is that cool?
It's the coolest.
I
love Mexico. I don't know. I've been coming here for many years, even before I was coming here to
just
play
for
music.
Fun.
Yeah, just for fun, because it's fun. You guys are fun.
Yeah,
we're fun. Okay.
Straight up.
Dice que viene a México porque parecemos divertidos, que le gusta a los mexicanos. Yeah. Your story with music, it's not just the lost on you. I mean, because maybe a lot of people know you about that song.
Yeah.
But you've been doing songs for many other artists.
Que la gente
you've
la
been doing music your whole life,
pero
right?
Ella lleva haciendo música sí. toda su vida.
Yes.
Ella dice sí.
Yeah.
So how you start to write songs?
Well, I don't, you know, it's weird. I didn't like, I could sing, and then I was like, but how do you write songs? It was a big mystery to me.
Okay.
I thought, like, yeah.
Like, really, like,
it's not the same sing than write.
It was more mysterious than, like, where babies come from, you know? It was
like, you're like, and Paris is not the answer.
Yeah, like, exactly. I understand that, but I don't understand where songs come from. And then I just started, I don't know, it started from nothing and just started, like, making stuff up, you know? And so, and then I would try to sing them, and I was trying to get noticed, and it took a long time. But then I got, you know, a record deal, then another record deal, another record deal, and then I started, and then I thought I was not going to be an artist anymore, and I became a songwriter.
Okay.
And that's when I really discovered myself the most, because I had to write so many songs. When you're a songwriter, you know, you're making money off songwriting, so you have to write many, many songs. And I think that was a time when it really kind of happened, because I just like it helped me to learn about myself and become myself as a writer, as an artist, you know. I think so. It was really it's very interesting to become a songwriter, and it's the best part of, like, I think what I like doing. You know, I love singing and everything, but without songwriting I would be
Okay, voy a traducir lo que dice un poquito.
Okay, sí.
Decía que
a ver si te acuerdas,
o sea, sabía que podía cantar, pero no necesariamente escribir, que le parecía una cosa como mágica el poder escribir canciones, y que empezó a escribir canciones y de repente tuvo un contrato con una disquera, pero hacía canciones y hacía canciones y hacía canciones, y que llegó un punto en el que pensó que nunca iba a poder ser un artista, sino que nada más iba a componer canciones.
Y además, para ganar lana escribiendo, tienes que escribir muchas canciones.
And how do you feel when you were listening to your songs singing by someone else? Isn't that weird?
I think that's the coolest thing ever.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I mean, first of all, because these artists, these huge artists, like, they could sing anybody's song they want to. Mm-hmm. So it's quite an honor.
It's like a privilege. You know, they're singing your song.
Yeah, and it's also fun to see another singer that I think is great and I respect to the interpretation of how they sing my song.
Yeah, but about the interpretation, it's not like, that was not supposed to be like that, you know?
Yeah.
It was
interesting because when Rihanna was going to do my song, I was like, you know, and I sang the demo for the song. So I thought, oh, she's going to change everything, you know? And She didn't change anything.
Really?
She like, didn't change it?
No. She just put a couple of her little, you know, dope runs in there, you know.
little Rihanna.
But, yeah, little Rihanna. She had to put some Rihanna in there. Yeah. But it was very simple.
Voy a traducir rápido. Por ejemplo, le preguntaba yo que si no era como una cosa especial o diferente escuchar sus canciones en la voz de alguien más. Y decía, no, que le parece un privilegio, por ejemplo, que estas artistas o estos artistas en general que tienen esa voz, como en el caso de Rihanna, pudiera cantar una de sus canciones. Y le preguntaba que si de repente no sentía que le habían cambiado cosas. Y decía, no, Rihanna cantó la canción como yo la había hecho en el demo. En el demo le puso un poquito de Rihanna, pero en realidad no le había cambiado prácticamente nada.
Y que se siente chido también ver a otro artista cómo va a interpretar su canción, ¿no? Lo que ella hizo. But when you write a song for you, maybe you have like a commitment with yourself that I don't want to say that or I want to say that. Yeah. But for example, when you write a song for another people, maybe you don't have this issue, no? You can write.
Yeah, it's like for it example, takes me like you're out in of a myself. Character, no? Yeah, exactly. It's like acting or something like that.
Yeah.
And, you know, I just like, I kind of like don't, I don't have to, I mean, I have to resonate with it. I stopped, like, I used to like try to like, someone's public persona, I go like, oh, I read somewhere that they just broke up with their okay, boyfriend, yeah, sure. And then I'm like, they must be sad. So I try to write a sad song.
You try to feel sad.
Yeah, and then I meet the person. I actually wrote with this person with them after that, and I was like, are you okay? They're like, yeah, I'm great. I was perfect, you know. Yeah. It was mutual. I was like, you know what? I'm just going to write what I feel and like make it universal. And I think, I don't know, I felt better after that.
Time to translate. Facundo decía que si, como que cuando compones para alguien más, no tienes ningún problema de yo no soy eso, no quisiera decir eso, y te conviertes como en un personaje. Y sí, es muy bueno. Si yo de repente conozco una historia de alguien que acaba de romper una relación, y entonces es como, oh, tengo que sentirme mal. Y decía, sí, o sea, claro. Al final logras ese sentimiento, pero cuando te preguntan cómo estás, no, pues estoy bien. O sea, no hay ningún problema, estoy bien.
It was actually Leona Lewis who and it was a while ago, you know, many, like a bunch of years ago, but it was Leona Lewis who's
Leona said, Lewis,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah. Cuz she also like she all her songs like she's so good at like ripping your heart out.
Okay.
And anything, she's incredible. But yeah, it was so funny when we had a session together and she was like, "Yeah, no, it was great. We're fine. We're good great friends." And I was
la canción la estaba comprendiendo con Leona Lewis, que tiene una capacidad increíble para arrancarte el alma con
and the song that I wrote for her without her, she didn't use, and the song we wrote together, she used. So it was just like, okay.
Okay, this is, you have like a good, how do you say it in English? Like a good relationship with all those artists that you write for them.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know all of them. I don't know all of them, but the ones that I mean, you know, collaborating is very much like what we're doing here. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like, you don't walk in like, hey, asshole.
Hi.
Hey, let's make magic.
Yeah, you know, from like, the other side of the table, right? It's like, oh, yeah.
Can we do magic now?
Yeah, exactly. Well, it's, okay. Yeah, it's like, you know, it's like speed dating or something.
Sí, es como cuando tienes una cita rápida. Yo la te siento. Ah, ya, la siguiente vez. Okay. And then, after many songs, suddenly you put Lost on You in like 20 or 30 countries around the world in number one. That has to be something, and suddenly you see yourself in the mirror, and then
I can do it. Yeah,
I can do it.
I can sing my
now
own songs.
I'm LP. I'm not a songwriter, which is great, but it's not just a songwriter. Now I'm LP,
and
now
then she realized. Then she realized how can own with these songs. No, how can we get with singing?
Yeah.
His own songs, no?
Yeah.
Their own songs.
No, I mean, I it was, thank God I was prepared and I had done it a bunch, you know. But I had so many songs ready to go, and I'm really happy that people got to know me through Lost on You, just because, mm-hmm, I feel like it was the perfect, cuz it's got all the parts of me in it. So it was very cool, because I feel like sometimes you don't get to pick what song makes you go, you know. But I was very happy that that song was the one, because it's, I don't know, I love it, and it shows many sides of my voice and my personality.
Okay. Y le estaba preguntando que de repente,
canta,
sí, que de repente un día, era el 2017, y LP pone Lost on You como una de las canciones más populares en el mundo, número uno en un montón de países en todo el planeta. Dice, pues eso tiene que haber sido algo. Dice, no, creo que me parece que Lost on You era la canción perfecta porque tiene muchas cosas de mí para hacer la canción con la que el mundo llegó a conocerme. To me, Lost on You, I don't know why, maybe visual. I've seen something about, but it looked like the desert. You're in the middle of the desert. You're lost in the
desert.
You're
lost in you.
You're lost in the desert, right?
Picture this.
Yeah, picture this.
You're in the desert.
You're lost in the desert.
You don't have no water.
Yeah, I know.
For days. I mean, that's what that relationship felt like at the time.
Yeah.
I was like,
you were lost there.
I was lost. I was lost and dying of thirst, yes.
Really?
It's a hard song to sing it, no?
It's a hard song, It's
like you can sing it at 8 o'clock in the morning. I mean, it's impossible.
I'm not sure. We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
I'll try.
Can we try?
Just know that it's 8 o'clock in the morning. Yeah. But
a lot of skills.
We shouldn't say it's 8 o'clock in the morning.
For singing that song, no?
Sí. Bueno, le vamos a pedir al Pique que por favor cante Lost on You, please.
That one, you're gonna sing that one?
Yeah.
Do you want me to sing that one first?
Yeah, that one first. That would be cool.
If you can.
Whatever you want.
Well, Lost on You con LP. LP va a pasar. Acá de este lado ya tenemos guitarra. Y le decía yo que a mí me suena como si se hubiera perdido en el desierto.
Sí, y dijo que
sí. Y dijo que sí. Que sí. Que estaba como en ese momento de la relación.
El desierto, güey.
Como
el
si estuviera video. En el desierto, como en el video. Y está con nosotros, va a cantar completamente en vivo. LP aquí en Yaparate.
Para los que están nada más escuchando en radio, LP está afinando su ukelele.
Ajá.
Está, ¿cómo se llama el señor guitarrista que está ahí?
Greco.
Greco está con nosotros también.
Yes. Greco a su lado, ya también afinado. Unos pedalitos ahí para dar acá
un efecto chido.
Unos toquecitos, unos delays.
Whenever
ahí.
You're ready.
All right.
Okay.
Plain and saner, will you remember all the danger we came from? Burning like embers, falling tender, longing for the days of no surrender years ago. And we're an old. So smoke them if you got them, 'cause it's going down. Understand the toil of expectations in your mind. Hold me like you never lost your patience. Tell me that you love me more than hate me all the time. Then you're still mine. So smile, come if you got them, 'cause it's going down. Turn around. Oh!
nosotros en Ya Párate. Vamos a hacer un corte, pero regresamos porque nos va a presentar su nuevo sencillo aquí en Los 40. So, we'll be back after these messages. Right. Ahorita regresamos a Ya Párate.
Wow.
But we're still on the streaming. We'll be back after these messages. I know. Wow, that vibrator is amazing. Wow. How did you do that?
I don't know.
It's great. I don't know, but that sounds cool. Okay. No. It's impossible. Almost.
Let me punch you in the
mouth. Okay, We ask you to join us here because we are going to be on the streaming. Okay, wow. That sounds good.
How do you deal with the fame? Because when you start to write, nobody knows you in the street, no? It's like you're going to for a coffee and it's like a regular person.
No, you were listening to your song maybe in Starbucks, right? Nobody knew you were that songwriter, right?
Yeah, it's cool. It's interesting. It's like and it's all different places that I go. I'm like at different levels sometimes. Like even in my own country, I do better than I ever thought I'd do, even in my own country. I never thought about being outside of my own country. That I can't believe. But it's interesting to like kind of gauge it. I don't really think about it. And then sometimes when it's many people know me, I'm like, oh wow. This is wild. Like, I go from a country, like I went from this place where I was very, very well known and everybody in the streets always come after me. And then I went home in L.A. And also in L.A., people always leave you alone anyway.
Yeah.
But I went home to L.A. and it was so funny because I was like 2 weeks of people going like, hey, can I take a photo or something like that? And some guy comes up to me with his phone and I was just about to put my arm around him like, and he goes, the Starbucks, is it like that? And I was like, oh, shit. And I was like, whoa.
Let me translate that.
So embarrassing.
Okay. Le decía Facundo que cómo ha manejado ahora el tema de la fama, porque pues a lo mejor antes estaba...
Sí, tuvo la mitad de su carrera, era anónima.
En un lugar donde podía estar escuchando una canción, decíamos ahorita en Starbucks, estaba escuchando una canción y a lo mejor la gente que estaba alrededor no sabía. Y hoy... De repente llega y se ha vuelto una persona popular en todo el planeta y a pesar de ser popular en Estados Unidos, que es su país, pues ahora también llega a otras partes del mundo y la gente la conoce, ¿no? Y entonces de repente decía que un día en Los Ángeles, pues ya la gente llegaba a sacarse fotos y tal, y alguien se acerca con un teléfono, ella estaba así como, bueno,
abrazándolo,
la siguiente
así,
foto, y
sonriendo.
De repente dice, oye, ¿no sabes dónde está esta dirección? Sí, claro que sí. For example, he hates photographs.
Yeah, I hate it.
I don't give a shit. I was like,
okay.
Smile
every time.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I do the face and then I'm good. You know, but like, I don't know. I just feel like it's so sweet of someone to come up and you know, if they like your music. I don't know. It's just like I could never be like, yeah, no. I don't know.
Cachetada de humildad.
And sometimes I don't know. People may come to you and say your song changed my life, or I met someone through your songs, or the day of my wedding I want to put your song there, and that's like blow mining, right?
Yeah, and it's just like again, it's like a great honor, you know, I don't take it lightly. I like to I like to honor that that whole part of the reason why I did this in the first place, you know. It's like, you know, and the whole famous thing is very makes you uncomfortable, but you do want to reach a lot of people, you know. So being famous is just a byproduct of what I do, but
sure.
And it's very, very, you know, it's weird and wild and all that stuff, but definitely it was just about, you know, with music. I would never want to be famous for no reason.
Okay.
Or for a bad reason.
Sure, sure.
Let me translate that, because I think it's important. Many people want just to be famous. I don't want to put that down,
but I can't imagine. I don't know, unless it was just something I loved doing. You know, I'd be like, oh wow, that's, because it's a lot of work and it's a little bit wild.
Okay, voy a traducir eso porque hablando de la fama es que el tema de ser famoso o de tener fama en el mundo, lo importante es hacerlo para llegar a más gente. O sea, dice, la fama en sí no es el asunto principal. Yo le decía, pues hay gente que se vuelve famosa por cualquier cosa. O sea, no, o sea, el tema aquí es un asunto complicado, necesita de mucho trabajo, pero si es para llegar a más gente con la música y porque es algo que realmente ama, pues adelante, ¿no?
I think that there are two kind of artists, no? The artist in your case who's a writer and the artist who's a performer. So when you give that big step, you don't get scared, like, no, well, I'm gonna be.
Yeah. For example,
you almost being a rock star.
Corona Capital is going to be like 100,000 people just.
Yeah, and no, but I say
just
wait,
in front of you, right?
Not fun, you know. To I like performing.
In the mic, please.
You gotta use the microphone, right?
Oh yeah.
Because we're in streaming too.
It's not just for spinning. Yeah, no. Sorry about that. Yeah, I mean, it's fun. I mean, it's fun to. I think you know people need to. Like, it's to me, it's like the connection is the performing. You know, I think that people, it's got to be visual. You got to see what it is. And it's and when you, like, interact and perform, like, you're connecting with people. And it really makes the experience so much bigger and more beautiful, I think. So I love that part, too, you know. I mean, it's super fun.
Well, but yeah. I'm saying that the scaring part is when you make the step that I'm gonna write this song for me. It's like, okay, this is gonna be my first song that I'm gonna sing. It's not like, wow, it's a big responsibility.
Yeah,
no?
I mean, I didn't like, I feel like, I guess it's weird. I guess I always consider myself an artist. Even in there was like that 2-year period where I only wrote songs for other people, and that was. It was wild, and I was actually happy to like not have to deal with people like scrutiny and people like, you know, being like, what's your image? What are you doing? You know, all these things. And that was kind of fun.
Why the rings? Why the hair? Why
Like, exactly. What's your single? What is your sound? What are you doing? And then,
sing for us.
Yeah, exactly.
And give me a part of you.
Exactly. And then when I wrote for other people, then it was like, oh, perfect. I don't have to worry about that, and I can just concentrate on writing songs. And then in those years, all of a sudden, I started playing ukulele, and it was fun. And then I started writing these songs for me. Mm-hmm. And I think one of the first songs I wrote for me that I knew, like, oh shit, this is like for me only, was Into the Wild, you know. And then I was like, and it had the whistle and everything, and I was like, and my managers were like, the hell is this? Like, this, you can't give this to anybody. This is you, you know. And it was fun.
You can do whatever you want.
Yeah. Estamos de regreso en Ya Párate. Para la gente que nos está escuchando, estamos de vuelta. LP está con nosotros aquí en la cabina y estábamos hablando de, bueno, fue cuando le preguntaba acerca de cómo fue dar el paso de repente hacer canciones, estar en el escenario. Sí, que pues sí, durante dos años disfrutó.
Como el brinco, ¿no? O sea, como que hacer esta canción ya es para mí. O sea, esto ya no es para nadie más.
Y ese Facundo es que de repente llega la gente y te dice, es que tienes que verte así, ¿por qué usas esto y tal? Y cuando componía las canciones para alguien más durante dos años, pues se olvidó de todo eso y simplemente hacía la música, las canciones. Pero llegó un momento en el que, entre el silbido, encontró como ese personaje. Y cuando entregó esa canción, sus managers le dijeron, no, esto no lo tiene que cantar nadie más. O sea, esto lo tienes que hacer tú. Esta es tu personalidad, ¿no?
Claro.
Y así de repente surgió LP. You're going to be in Corona Capital, which is for us like a huge festival.
What's going to be is like in 1 week, ¿no?
It's this weekend, right?
Yeah.
Do you enjoy being in those festivals? Because my question is around, there's a huge crowd, there are many bands, and people may know some of your songs, but some other guys, they're just there to watch somebody else.
Yeah.
And when you write your own songs,
your own public,
and you put your soul in your songs, for me, or to me, I wish everybody was looking at me, listening to me, right?
I mean, last time I played it, everybody was looking at me, but I have had festivals where, you know, I've had, like, I remember I played right before the Strokes at a festival in the States, and, you know, I had all my people there, too, but there was, like, a bunch of, like, and the Strokes are one of my favorite bands in the world, but there was, like, you know, probably like 100 or 200 people right in the front with like Strokes t-shirts on, like
waiting for the next
waiting
band.
For
yeah,
them.
And I
waiting
and I said like, and, wow, I just said moment. No, but they were cool. I just said like I said, yo, what's up? I was like, the Strokes are my favorite band too. Holy crap! Thanks for coming. Sorry to ruin your lives right now.
Sorry for ruining really? Your
sorry for
2 hours.
Yeah, they just like laughed and then they were like, you know, like you know, I just like
okay,
you know.
Let's give it a chance. Let's give it a chance. Okay. Estaba preguntándole acerca de esos festivales porque pues hay muchas bandas, hay mucha gente que va a escuchar a un montón de artistas, que si de repente no es como choqueante que tú estás ahí, pero hay público de otros artistas que tú estás en el escenario y no necesariamente te están poniendo atención. Cuando tú haces tus canciones, lo que quieres es que la gente te escuche. Y nos contaba una anécdota de un festival en el cual estuvo antes de los Strokes. Ajá. Y entonces decía
que es su banda favorita,
que es una de sus bandas favoritas. Y decía, pues sí, hasta adelante había un montón de fans de los Strokes viéndome con una cara de pues, a ver a qué hora acaba, ¿no?
Para
que empiecen los Strokes. Y que subió al escenario y con mucha naturalidad dijo: hola a todos, ¿cómo están? Sí, están esperando los Strokes, es una de mis bandas favoritas también.
Perdón por arruinarles.
Perdón por arruinarles este momento y que ya pues, les causó gracia y que a partir de ese momento pues ya compartieron el
escenario. En México lo hubieran bajado a monedazos, ¿no? En el Vive Latino.
The crowd in Mexico is it's a little aggressive, you know.
Yeah, I mean, I think you know the Strokes fans were nothing compared to like the Cure fans.
Okay.
Yeah, they were like they're different.
Yeah, they were basically like, you know, like in the makeup and, yeah. And just like, you know, completely like punk rock, like kind of like see, like it, sending me death.
It's like
death stares, daggers.
Like, I'm gonna see like, two steps behind.
Yeah,
right?
I'm just like, I'm just beat Jim Morrison and sing to the back
helmet,
of the stage.
No?
Yeah, give me a
I
helmet.
I need a helmet.
Sorry.
Sing with a helmet.
Yeah, this woman looked like she was literally gonna like spit in my face the whole time.
Que los fans de Strokes son leve yeah. comparado con los de The Cure, ¿no? Sí. Que los de The Cure yeah. te dan miedo, que te quieren, que te ven con cara de muérete.
Sí, sí, que te van a escupir en la cara.
Que sale con casco.
So you're looking forward to singing in el Corona Capital.
I'm so looking forward to singing in Corona Capital and in Mexico again. It's like, you know, with the pandemic and everything, it's like you have to tack on a whole year. Mm-hmm. Like, I haven't played here in 2 years, even yeah. though it feels
you're
like 1 year.
You're like a lion in a cage,
it
no?
feels like 1 year, and it's now it's been 2 years. So, yeah. like, I mean, I couldn't be happier, and I'm just so excited, and I hope, you know, even the people that are going to be standing there and in their disclosure shirts.
You're a headliner.
Like,
no, everybody sure knows you. You're a headliner in the Corona Capital.
So, yeah,
don't
no,
worry
it's
about
gonna be,
it.
It's gonna be
yeah, yeah. Thank
you.
The other band's gonna have
yeah. They should
that
be worried because yeah.
no.
we're here for LP. So, let them worry. Don't worry about it. You're a headliner, so you know we're very passionate, and I hope
oh, I know.
You get all that passion from Mexico this Saturday. I hope you
yes.
get it,
yes.
And you enjoy it as much as we're going to do being yeah. there in El Corona Capital. But right now, we have something exclusive. We're going to listen to your new song.
The new one?
I believe people is not able to listen to it in Spotify, right? Not yet. Tomorrow we'll be
oh, which
here
one?
In Mexico.
Are you sure?
Really?
Are you sure you're saying the right song?
Yeah.
Don't scare me now.
No, if you are sure,
you're going to listen. You're going to perform that song.
Okay,
right?
Cool. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah?
We, yeah.
It's okay because in right? Mexico we're not ready. Or
do you know how to
okay?
play? Do you know how to play?
It's available already. Okay.
Okay,
I thought
okay.
we were going to listen it for the first time.
Oh, okay.
But do you know how to play it?
I know how to play it. But,
are you sure?
But I didn't know if like I was like, what the hell song is he talking? I don't know.
They told me this is just
this is a secret
for Mexico.
Song. It's she hasn't even
time.
Written it yet. I'd be like,
yeah. Okay, I'm gonna
improvise
something
for you now. It's about Mexico.
This is so exclusive.
Bueno, vamos a escuchar la nueva canción de LP. Aquí en Los 40. Thank you for being with us.
Thank
it's been
you.
An honor.
Thank
it's been
you.
Great.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks, everybody.
Nice to meet you.
Así que para
pleasure,
toda la gente
pleasure.
Que nos escucha en Los 40 y a través del streaming, LP está con nosotros. Ok. Apláudanos.
Yeah. Oye, thanks. ¿No pensabas que LP era súper seria, no?
Sí, también. No.
Resultó ser bien cábula, ¿no? Yo pensaba que era como... No sé,
imagínate
como...
dos tequilas después lo que esto podría ser. ¿Eh?
Ajá, exacto. Imagínate lo que va a ser el Corona Capital, ¿no?
Say tequila? Did you?
Yeah, it's a tequila.
This would be like after two tequilas. Okay, I heard jokes tequilas, and I was like,
you don't speak Spanish, but you did understand tequila.
Sure.
It's like gold. It's like a world wild word.
Sí, sí, eso. Nos acredita como mexicanos. Nos acredita como mexicanos totalmente.
There's no a translate for that word, ¿no? O sea, no hay traducción para tequila.
Hangover es la translation de.
No.
Ah, oh, yeah.
Ready?
Yeah, I think so. This is even higher than last time, you think.
Yeah?
Wish me luck, okay? Yeah.
Substance, a dealer, the wiser, the realer, the sun coming up and the touch of a healer. The days of our lives, the first time that I saw her, the eyes of a savior, loved her and lost her. And I don't know why, all I do is try. It's a lonely night that talks to me, talks to me. And it takes its toll on the sweetest soul. To release in a peace and to tell yourself to let it go. Goodbye to less than goodbye. Goodbye to wasting more time. To all of the darkness where there should be light. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. What's next? The subtext is complex, and in the end we're all just having the same sex. Your heroes, your demons, you're taught to believe in. They change with the season. Yeah, fuck them, don't need them. And I don't know why, all I do is try. It's a lonely night that talks to me, talks to me. Takes a real shit show with a heart of gold. To release in a peace and to tell yourself to let it go. Goodbye to less than goodbye. Goodbye to wasting more time. To unlove the darkness where there should be light. Goodbye, goodbye. Goodbye, let's say hello to tomorrow. Adios, au revoir, arrivederci. I sing in any language, lepi, yasu, dos, vidania, odabo. Goodbye, let's say hello to tomorrow.
We have to.
Thank you so much, everybody.
LP con nosotros aquí en Ya Párate. Gracias, gracias. Nosotros regresamos a radio.
Thank you very much, LP.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Goodbye, arrivederci.
Goodbye, arrivederci. Adios.
Adios. Gracias. Regresamos a Ya Párate.
Chingón.
Great. Nice. Amazing. That sounds amazing.